Hello everybody, welcome to Word Shard.
In today's class, we are going to solve the rest of the questions from the poem, The Patriot. And these are also the other important questions which may come in your ICSE exam. We'll continue with it and there are maybe 6 to 7 questions and then we'll be done with it. Question number C. Okay, so let's read the extract. There is nobody on housetops now, just a palsied few at the windows set. For the best of the sight is all allow at the shambles gate, or better yet, by the very scaffold's foot I trow. So, what is the question from here? Compare the scene. You are told to compare. This is an important question because it is a constant comparison between 1 year back and now. Okay, so this question might come. This is an important question. Compare the scene on the housetops a year ago and now as mentioned in the above extract. What does it signify? You have 4 marks over here. The question may come like this also, that how he was welcomed in a year back and what is the situation now. Then you can also say that they were showering flowers like roses and myrtles on him 1 year back and now they're throwing stones at him. But in this question, it is mentioned that what is the scene on the housetops now and before. So here you have to mention only this part. So what you will write, in the glory-filled past, that is in the golden past of his time, the poet puts forward the image of house roofs which seem to sway. Isn't it? You remember that heaving and swaying movement? It seemed that the housetops were moving as a huge number of people had gathered on the terraces, on the roofs, and they were waving their hands to welcome the patriot. They were waving their hands and that is why it seemed so many people raising their hands and waving it on the terrace. It seemed that the tops of the houses were itself swaying, moving. Okay, so this scene, and what is the other scene? Now, just the next year, there was nobody on the housetops. This is the important point. Nobody on the housetops now. He had changed from, why has this happened? Just mention in one line that from a beloved leader, he has become a condemned traitor. People think that he is a traitor. They cannot trust him anymore. They hate him and they want him dead. People were excited to see him die. They were all excited that, okay, today he will be hanged, and they are so excited. They have all gathered at the shambles gate. Now, question number two. What do you mean by the best of the sight? The sight that the people awaited. Okay, when we are waiting for something very excitedly, that, oh my God, I'm going to watch maybe Tom and Jerry show or maybe this movie. So the best sight is that. But over here, what is the best sight? The best sight is what the people waited for. What did the people wait for? It is to see the patriot being hung in the gallows. So they were waiting when it would be time for the patriot to be hung. They were very excited to see that. What does it say about the common people's nature? This is important because this identifies the theme of the story, of the poem. Marks allotted is 2. The poem portrays the public fickle-mindedness. This is the important word. Remember it. Public fickle-mindedness. Or you can write that they are not constant in what they believe. Okay, they will just shift from this side to that side. Only a year ago, he was godlike to his men. They could sacrifice anything for him. And now he has changed into the condemned traitor. For him, they could sacrifice anything once upon a time. Okay, but now they wish to see him humiliated and finally dead. They humiliate him like anything. They throw stones at him. They tie his hands so tightly and they are so excited to see him dead. And finally, if he is dead, they would be satisfied the most. Okay, now we'll move to the next extract, question D. Let's read the extract first. I go in the rain and more than needs a rope cuts both my wrists behind and I think by the feel my forehead bleeds for they fling whoever has a mind stones at me for my year's misdeeds. What is the first question? Where is I going in the rain? Where is he going? This is a very easy question. Only 1 mark is here. So you'll just write I is being taken to the gallows or he is going towards the shambles gate. He is going to be hung from there. Okay. You can also mention why, because people thought that he has become a traitor, he has done a lot of wrong things. For his misdeeds, he is going to be hung that day. What does the next part, what does the rain symbolize? This is an important question. What is the symbol? why is it raining? Is it just like that, that the poet feels that it should rain at this moment, or is there a particular reason for it? I told you it is a pathetic fallacy. It is quite like personification, somewhat like personification, where rain, which is a natural element, is attributed human emotions. Okay, in a personification, we see inanimate substances are provided human qualities. For example, the table crying, this is a personification. But in this case, the natural objects are attributed or given human emotions and feelings. Over here, we feel that nature is weeping, nature is crying. Why is it crying? To see the leader humiliated in such a way. The nature also, here nature, Mother Earth, even the sky, the blue sky, the clouds, everybody is feeling sorry, and that is why it is raining. It seems that nature is also crying at such humiliation. The rain also tries to, you can also write this, that the rain tries to balm. When it is very hot and it rains, you feel very, you know, very, there is a lot of, you feel very happy when it rains. You feel very calm down, isn't it? Similarly, the rain was trying to wash the wounds, the humiliation from his body. Okay, because the rain felt sorry for him. Washes him clean of the accusations. All that he was alleged, he was accused. So, rain was trying to wipe it out from his body. Rain was stopping or cleaning him from all this humiliation, because nature knew that he was not guilty. Okay. How is I taken to that place? How, in what state or in which process was he taken? The marks allotted over here is 3, so it needs to be a big answer. The speaker's hands were tied, point number 1. His wrists got cut by the rope used to tie the hands behind. The hands were tied behind. This is also another half mark. Okay, and the rope was tied very tightly. That is another half a mark. He was being taken to the gallows. Okay, so this is another half mark. He was being taken to the gallows, or the place where he is going to be hung. The public that once regarded him as godlike threw stones at him. So this is another 1 point, that public was throwing stones at him. His forehead bled, half a mark. His forehead was bleeding. Why? Maybe one of the stones that were thrown at him had hit him badly and he was bleeding. He was drenched in rain. It was raining also, so he was drenched in rain. These are the important points. We'll move to the last extract from this chapter. Question E. Thus I entered and thus I go. In triumphs people have dropped down dead. Paid by the world, what dost thou owe me? God might question. Now, instead, it is God shall repay. I am safer so. Let's see the first question from here. Where do you think the speaker enters? Where is he entering? The speaker is entering the gate of death or the shambles gate. Anything you can write. If you write just this much, the shambles gate, then also it is correct. Next, where does he go after that? Now, when he is entering the shambles gate, we all know that what will happen to him? He will be hung. Okay, he will die. So then where he will go? He is ready to accept his life after death. He is ready to accept that he is going to die and then there is an afterlife. He will die and then he will have another form of life. And then he would go very close to God. And you know, God knows everything. God knows who is wrong and who is right, isn't it? So he will give him justice. So he is going to God where he will find justice. Okay. Next, question number 2. The speaker says, I am safer so. Where does he feel safe and why? This is another same type of a question, that why, where is he going and why does he feel safe over there? The speaker is going to God. This is the most important point. He will feel safe there. Now, the question is, why does he feel safe over there? Why? The world thought that the patriot had done something wrong. Now, the whole world was thinking that this man is a traitor. The patriot is a traitor and he should be punished, and that's it. That is why he was hung. So they decided to hang him for his misdeeds, because people misjudged him. According to the patriot, he felt that the people had misjudged him, and that is why they sentenced him to death. Okay, but the patriot thinks that death isn't the ultimate end, isn't it? Afterlife is also there. So he is soon going to be close to God. He is going to a place which is closer to God's home, and God, who knows everything. Okay, God knows everything, who has done wrong, who has done right. So he will give him justice. He will reward him. He did not get the reward from his own people. So he is sure that God will surely reward him. So he will be in God's safe hands. Okay, Last question from this chapter. Identify Browning's philosophy of life as is revealed through the poem. Even in the last, when we were doing the last part of the poem, when I was discussing it, I told you. This one is a very short answer, but 2 marks is allotted because of the idea, because it is very important. The two main ideas over here. One is optimism. Optimism means that the poet is very much optimistic. He has a positive outlook to life. Often we face a number of disasters in life. Maybe there is loss upon loss, there is failure upon failure, but then we should feel this way that soon there will be a good time. We will see a good time soon. So that is a kind of optimism. And its opposite is pessimism. That means that I am sad and I am depressed, that nothing good is going to happen to me. Then you become very depressed. Okay, then you lose all hope. So it is important that you be optimistic, you hold your faith and his belief in God. So this is the second thing. First, he is optimistic. Second, he believes in God. What was his message? Message is, God is in his heaven and all is well with the world. He's a religious person. He believes in God. He believes that surely you will get justice if you have done the right thing. You will not. God will never fail you. Okay. That's the whole chapter. That's the whole poem with all the questions, whichever was important. And if you have any other question which you want to ask or any other line that you did not understand, please write in the comment section. And I hope you have liked the video. If you have liked it, please subscribe and also share. Let your friends see it also. Thank you so much.